What's up, guys? It's Philip from the Honda Resource. Today I've got my 2005 Civic Hybrid up on the lift, and I'm going to be changing the oil and doing a valve adjustment. When it cold starts in the morning and I go to take off, when it's really cold, I say really cold, here in Alabama, really cold is, I don't know, in the 50s. So when it's in about the 50s, or 50 degree range, it has a little bit of valve chatter. Once it warms up, you don't really have it, so that tells me it really probably could use a valve adjustment. So I'm going to do a valve adjustment, and I'm going to change the oil. So I've watched a lot of reviews on Walmart SuperTech Full Synthetic, and it has really good reviews. So I've used this for a while in my personal vehicles, with the exception of the race car, because I use Valvoline VR1 in that. So I went down to Walmart, and I picked up some Full Synthetic 5W20 to put in the hybrid. And then I got a Wix filter from O'Reilly Auto Parts. Typically, I use these, the Denso oil filters. I pick up these on Rock Auto and actually buy these in bulk, like 6 to 12 at a time, because I use these in my shop. These are really good filters, and they're cheap on Rock Auto. I think they're like $3 a piece or something, so they're very affordable. I have used OEM Honda filters for quite a while, too. I actually use the Denso filters on my race car, so that tells you how much I believe in them. But like I said, I have, if you would like a OEM filter, then go for it. This car here I bought secondhand, and the oil had just been changed, so I haven't changed it yet. And I think it has, you can see the yellow filter there, it's a Pennzoil filter on it. I've driven a little further than I really should have on this oil change, but whatever. I think the oil was changed at like 97,000 miles, and I bought it at 98,000 miles, and now it has 110,000 miles. So yeah, I've put a little too many miles on the oil, but you know, I guess it's like they say, that you know, mechanics cars always come last. So it I've been working on everybody else's stuff and hadn't really made a point to get mine on the lift in here and actually do this stuff. So I got the lift clear for a second, and I decided to go ahead and put my car in here. So we're going to go ahead and drain this oil and switch it out real quick. All right, so on these, the drain plug is right here on the back of the oil pan, and it's like a 17 millimeter. Just use a wrench. Break that loose. Drain plug back in. Now if the flat washer on the drain plug was smashed out, probably be a good time to go ahead and put another washer on that. This one looks to be in good shape. You can get those at the Honda dealership also. They're just a little aluminum crush washer. The old filter here is about done draining. Another thing I like to do with especially customer cars and stuff is actually put my like shop's initials and a date on there for the change, just so that you know I can keep record of the last time I changed it if the car was to have some kind of issues. I have one car that's in here now. You see, this is November 15th of 2020. I have one car that's been up here, and I think the last time I looked at the filter on it, and the last time the oil had been changed that I changed it was in like January of 2019. That's almost 2 years ago. It was here for some other issues, not related to the oil, but still, that's a long time for an oil change. So I put some oil in the filter, like just poured it directly in. This one mounts vertical and it's not gonna spill out. Now if you put it in one of the Hondas where the filter goes on the back of the block, don't fill it all the way up because it'll spill out, or if it does spill out, just have a rag or something handy to catch the oil. But I don't like putting on a dry filter. It just don't sit well with me. So. And also on the little they have a little, I'll show you on this Denso filter here, but they have like a little rubber O-ring here on the surface. So I just take a little bit of oil and smear on the O-ring too before I put it on, just so the O-ring's not dry. All right, so that concludes everything on the bottom side that I need to do. Got my drain plugged tight, and I wiped it off, and got my filter installed, so now I can go ahead and let the car down and clean up my little mess here. Move my drain pan out over here out of the way. All right, so now we got the car lowered back down, and to install the oil, we just take the cap off here. You can see here, usually the newer Hondas, they'll have the oil weight recommendation right on the cap, which is, this says 0W20, so I guess the 5W20 is a little thicker than maybe I really should have put in it, but it's not going to hurt anything. It'll work just fine. I actually looked up on my phone while I was at Walmart to buy the oil. I'm just going to put about 4 quarts in it at first and check it, see how it looks. I think these take about 4.5. Most Hondas 4-cylinders take about 4.5. Let's see how much that is. It's about 3 quarts in there so far. Let's see what that looks like. Now, I probably won't give a true reading until I start it up and it fills up the filter and all that kind of stuff, but you get as close like this. See, that's showing actually full there, and it's isn't about 3.5 quarts in there. I know it's going to take more than that, but so if you're just doing an oil change, you can go ahead and start it up now and run it for just a second, turn it back off, let it sit for a second, and then you can check the oil again and go ahead and top it off accordingly. But since I'm doing a valve adjustment, the engine needs to be as cold as possible. So I'm not going to start it up just yet. I'm going to go ahead and do this valve adjustment. And we'll start it up after we're done. So on most of all of our Hondas, if you have an OEM hood on it, it's going to have your exhaust or your valve lash adjustments on here. So you can see the intake is 0.17 and the exhaust is 0.26. Yeah. 0.26. So that's our valve lash adjustments of what they need to be. So now we just got to pull like all this cover off to get to the valve cover and get the valve cover off. Another fun fact about the hybrid, they have 8 spark plugs. I didn't know that until I actually owned this car. I wasn't as familiar with the hybrid stuff, and I was gonna put some of these plugs in and do a tune-up, and I went to my dealer and I was like, yo, I need some spark plugs. And they're like, okay, 8 of them. And I was like, Jesus Christ, are you serious? And they were expensive at the dealer, so I chose not to do them at the time. So I actually probably need to do that. But anyway, yeah, it has 4 up here and 4 back here. All the spark. Now would be a good time to change the valve cover gasket too, if you were into that kind of stuff. I'm probably just going to reuse this one. It wasn't leaking and it seems to be still pretty soft, so good to go on that. If it was brittle, I'd definitely be replacing it. It's kind of weird, man. This thing has 8 spark plugs, but only 4 intake and 4 exhaust. That's wild, man. So typically, most four-cylinder Hondas have two valves per cylinder, so they have like two intake, two exhaust, so four valves per cylinder. This only has two valves per cylinder, so a little bit different than what I'm accustomed to seeing, but hey, whatever. I guess if it works, it works. All right, so the next thing we got to do is get it to top dead center, and I don't know if you can see, but on the gear there, you can see like there's a number two right there. So whenever that number is up here, that's top dead center on number two. So what we got to do is get it over to cylinder one, and then we'll go in our firing order and adjust them accordingly. So to do that, I've removed the wheel over here on the passenger side, and the lug nuts are 19 millimeter if you need to remove yours. You could probably do this without removing the wheel, but for simplicity and video's sake, I went ahead and took it off. So we'll need to go through this spot here, and I believe that's going to be a 19 millimeter that goes through that and goes onto the crank pulley. Usually you can push the socket through. You may not want to go through that. Or we can just take these little clips here off. All right, so we can see that I got the little panel off here. It's just those two little clips, one here and one here. And then I was able to put my 19 millimeter on there, and on this, you have to turn it clockwise. That's the way this engine rotates, is clockwise, so don't turn it counterclockwise on this one. So I turned it clockwise and got it to where, let's see, it says up right there. Let's see, there we go. You can see it says up, and you can see the line that goes across. So that's the number one cylinder, which is going to be our exhaust and our intake. So it's just these two valves. All right, so we're going to adjust those real quick, and then they'll do the firing order, which is 1, 3, 4, and then 2. That's firing order. All right, so the those valve adjustment specs that were on the hood, the intake was 0.17, is like a 0.007 standard. 2.6 metric goes over to a 0.010, so that's the two I have. And then I also have my valve adjustment tool here, which is, move that a little bit. This is a Powerbilt tool, and you can pick these up off like Amazon or eBay or whatever. That's 10 millimeter version, which is what this is. Some Hondas take 12 millimeter version. This one doesn't though. And so intake is the smaller one, the 0.17. So this is the intake here. And honestly, it feels pretty good. Check our exhaust one. And I mean, honestly, both of these feel pretty good. So I'm gonna leave those two alone. And so then I'm gonna rotate it clockwise until my number three comes up right here. So let me show you that. See, it has a number three in the line, so that's how we know it's ready to do number three. All right, so again, we'll check these two. I mean, really, that one feels pretty good too. That one's got a little more slack than I would like, so I'm probably gonna tighten that one down just a hair. So the way this thing works is that there's a nut on the outside, and then this little screw in the center, it's got a flathead in it. So this holds the nut, and then this part turns the screw. So we had to break the nut part loose with our handle, like that. And then you turn the center until you get the desired drag you want on your valve adjustment tool. So that feels pretty good there. So then while we're holding the center still, you just turn the nut back and tighten it down so that it's basically a jam nut. It tightens it in place. So that one feels good now. We'll go to number four. Yep. Got our number four up. Check it real quick. All right, now we'll go over to cylinder two. Now we're back to cylinder two. Or we're at cylinder two. All So those feel good now. So I guess we're going to leave those alone where they're all at. I've got them all tightened back down. I've seen people that want to torque those and stuff, but I've always found that just tighten them back down with our tool there, it does sufficient, and there's really no need to torque it. So now I'm just going to wipe this gasket mating surface off and get this valve cover stuck back on here. I have to go to work here in a little bit, so it'd be nice to have my car back. And also on this, you don't ever want to wipe the oil or the mating surface here towards the inside of the engine, because a lot of dirt likes to get up here and sit on the edge, and you don't want to be raking that dirt over into your engine. So wipe it away from it. All right, so now done with that part of it, let's see if we can get this thing reassembled. All right, so now that we've got it all put back together, I'll start it up and let it run for a second and shut it off and check the oil level. All right, so that should be sufficient to enough for us to check the oil level. Let it sit here for a second and let the oil drain back down to the pan, and we'll check it. I'm sure I'm gonna have to add a little bit. Cap off. See what it looks like. Yeah, it's about a half quart low. So go ahead and throw a little bit more in here, and then we'll be good to go. All right, that should do us. See how that looks. Give it a second to get down to the oil pan. It's right on the money, so good to go there. Put our oil cap back on, and then I have to put this wheel back on, but otherwise it's done. All right, and then last but not least, we need to reset our oil light. You see the maintenance required light up here at top that stays on. So that's our oil light, and to reset that, all right, so what we need to do is hold this down, our select right here, hold this down, we'll turn the key on, not start the car, just turn the key on, and then this should blink here in about 10 seconds and then go off. You see our light goes off. That's how you reset that, and then we can start the car. All right, you can see our oil light is now off. So thanks for joining me on this episode. I know it kind of rambled along, and I really didn't get too detailed with the valve adjustment because there really wasn't a lot to adjust on mine. I was thinking maybe it was a little more than that, but turns out it was just a couple loose exhaust valves. So we went ahead and got those tightened up to spec, and hopefully now in the morning when I go to leave work, we'll be able to tell if it made a difference or not. So as always, I appreciate the subscribes, the likes, the comments, all that stuff. It doesn't cost you anything, but it helps me tremendously. So I really appreciate those. Yeah, hope to see you again on another video. There's also more on my channel for the 7th Gen Civic. Unfortunately, there's not a ton of information on there for the hybrids. This is the first one I've ever had over here, And I've just done a few little small things, nothing to really speak about. Anyways, guys, thanks again. See you on the next one. Peace.